Welcome to Women's Wealth, the podcast with me, Joanne. My mission is to educate, inspire, and empower you all to step into your own life of wealth. That feeling of being so rich in your mind, body, and soul. I'm so happy to have you here. Let's get straight into it.
Hello. Welcome back to another episode of Women's Wealth with me, your host, Joanne. I'm so happy to have you here. Welcome back if you're returning, especially you guys that have supported me this whole way. And welcome, welcome, welcome if you've just found me. I'm excited for many reasons. First of all, we're on the journey to 10,000 downloads. So please, please like and subscribe if you enjoy what you listen or watch on YouTube today. And yeah, every download counts. And who would have thought? Well, I wouldn't definitely not have thought that I, little old me, would have a podcast of nearly 10,000 downloads. So please, please keep them coming. And thank you, thank you, thank you for everyone that does download. It really is, like, it melts my heart. And different timing for recording today. I'm recording under the new moon. So I'm recording at sunset, or after sunset. So hopefully you can see me okay on YouTube, but I wanted to really step into the magic of the new moon as I was recording today. I am on my own, no guest. I do have an amazing guest episode already recorded for next week. And today I wanted to retouch on a topic. Now, I have done a couple of podcasts recently about witches, the witch wound. And it's one of the most, not going to say requested, that's the wrong word, but it's the topic that when I see people, they're like, oh my God, I loved that podcast when you talked about witches, the witch wound. And I think a lot of women obviously resonate with it so much, because when you hear someone talking about the witch wound and finding your inner witch, it's something that we resonate with, and it's something we want to get back in touch with. Today, not talking about the witch wound so much, not going into the history of witches so much. Obviously, I'll mention it because it all comes under, you know, the healing. What I want to talk about today is stepping into your magic. Whether or not you resonate with witches, witchcraft, spirituality, manifestation, whether you think it's all woo-woo or it's something that you follow, I want to appeal to all of you today. So yes, I'm going to talk about magic, but I'm also going to talk about science, and I'm also going to cover on how using some of these routines, these rituals, can help us not only physically, but mentally, emotionally. It actually can help us holistically to step into a life of health or wealth. So that's what I'm going to touch on today. A little bit of magic, a little bit of science, a little bit of history, and a lot of my own sort of, not feedback, my own experiences with this, because I'm on my own journey here too. And I wanted to share that with you, because I know that just for myself, when I hear other women, they're sharing their journey, I'm like, oh yes, I'm not alone. And that's what I want to get across as well today. So there might be just one thing that I say today and you're like, yes, let's do it. There might be a few things. First of all, I want to start with reminding you on how magical you actually are. Whether you believe in magic or witchcraft or not, think about it. First of all, you are a human that has a bunch of random souls that came together because two random people met each other and had an emotional connection that we call love. They then committed an act. We don't need to go into what parents did, but their souls came together and they knew what to do and how to create you as a human that can bleed, breathe, has a beating heart that knows how to keep you alive, as well as organs that detoxify your body. Know what food you need. We know what food we need to eat. We have a brain. We can do all these amazing things. We're also on a giant floating rock in out of space, infinite space, circulating around a giant, ginormous ball of fire. We have a moon, which is also another big rock that floats next to us in our orbit without crashing into us, but it also helps us and controls our tides. We have day and night that happen naturally, and we're just floating out here in outer space, and somehow it's been happening for millions and millions of years, and we have millions and millions of years old civilization. I could go on, but it's crazy. And then people tell me that magic's not real, miracles are not real. What's the point? That's the point. So really just take a moment, and it makes you feel so small yet so special. So we are magic. We are a miracle. It's a miracle that we're here simply for all of the things that I've just said. So if you're a little bit skeptical, even that surely must blow your mind, because it does mine every time I think about it. Every time I look at the moon, I'm like, oh my God, how is that thing just not crashing into us? How are we just floating around? And when I see pictures of the universe is and the black holes, and it blows my mind. Maybe I should do a podcast on that, because I can talk about that all of the forever. Just the fact that it blows my mind. My tiny brain cannot wrap itself around infinity, infinite space, and how we are here today, how I am talking to you, recording it on a device, sending it to you, and then you're going to watch it in your house. Blech. Crazy. Anyway, you are magic. You are a miracle. As women, we also have this deep connection with the earth, and I'm really going to drive this in today's podcast. I want you to imagine yourself as your own planet. We have the water within us, saliva, blood. We are 60% water. Like, we are water. We have air, just like the earth, which has the wind. We have air that we breathe. We also have our own. We have our breath. We need air. We have fire. The fire, we have electricity within our bodies, our nerve endings. We also have fire metaphorically of our willpower, our drive, our passions of earth, our body, our grounding, our roots. We have all of the elements within us. We have our spirit, the fifth element, our soul. So we have this deep connection with Mother Nature, and we can really draw on the elements to help us to move forward. Once we see and understand and have that connection, it can really help you physically, because seeing yourself as Earth, how do you treat the Earth? Do you go out and throw junk all over the place? Do you nourish? Do you have a garden? Do you look after your garden? Just thinking about how you treat the Earth to how you then treat your body. And thinking about, do you eat a lot of junk food? Do you ignore your body? Do you exercise? Do you just put it off? Are you, do you go through lazy times? Yes, that's okay. But thinking about how would you want someone to be like that with your planet? We all have to share this planet. Does it annoy you when you see someone dropping litter on the street, or you see the pollution in the oceans, and you see that how the human race is having a big effect on the planet? Whether or not you believe in climate change, we can physically see when we go to the beaches that there's a lot of crap on the beaches. Do you want people to treat you, your body, like that? Just having that connection, again, it's stepping into the magic of being one with the universe. So how do we use this to move forward? And how do we use this to help ourselves? How do we use it to help us emotionally, first of all, or mentally? Because this is where a lot of us face blocks, our physical health, our mental health, our emotional health. Actually, one more thing before I go into this, because I want to share with you a little bit of a history lesson here. I nearly forgot about this. I was reading about goddesses, history of et cetera, the other day. And it was talking about in, I think it was 3000 BC. They were very, 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 very long time ago. They did not have the education, the understanding of where babies came from. And I'd never actually thought about this before, because it's known to us. it didn't say when people actually learnt where they came from, but a very long time ago, they had no idea. And at this time, there wasn't God. It was BC, before Christ. There wasn't anyone, this figure that people looked up to. It was actually women that were worshipped because of the fact that they had this connection with the earth, that they thought, if I get this right, that it was the moon that helped, that got women pregnant. And they worshipped women, and women worshipped the moon. And at that time as well, our cycles were probably about 28 days because we didn't have all this artificial light. I know women's hormones now average is 28, but think about all the crap that we have to put up with and that we put in our bodies and the artificial light. Back then, we would have rose with the sun, gone to bed with the moonrise, and we would have followed the moon's path. We would have known the time of year from the seasons. And women would have been center point of all of that. They would have bled with the full moon, ovulated with the new moon, new beginnings. You know, this is when life would have been created. How amazing is that? We've just lost that over the years because of modern life. And I know it's argued that the women's cycle has nothing to do with the moon, but I'll argue back that you're telling me it's just a coincidence that our bodies have the same 28 days as the moon. There's got to be more to it than that. And yes, like I've said, some women now have 30-day cycles, more or less, because of our modern life. We don't wake up with sunrise now. We don't wake up naturally now. We don't go to bed at sunset. We keep lights on while it's dark, artificial light. We've messed up our infradian rhythm. So of course we're going to lose that connection that way. Just a side note there before I got into everything else, because that blew my mind as well. I love that. I love that, first of all, they didn't have a clue that men had something to do with the baby making. They didn't put that together. Obviously, they were doing the baby making because there wouldn't be anyone here, but they didn't know that it took the sperm and the egg. It was the moon, and then women were worshipped because of that. So how do we connect then? How can we use magic to help us physically, emotionally, and mentally? So magic is not just about pulling a rabbit out of a hat or Paul Daniels or card tricks. Magic, witchcraft, spells, these are all things that we do all of the time without even realizing. Now, just to take it away from magic and turn it into the power of your words, whether you believe in magic or not, you know that if you're having a bad day and you're like, F this, F that, sod this, hate that, hate this, that makes you feel emotionally drained. So the magic of your words, if you're in a good mood and you meet someone in a bad mood, if you use your good, happy, joyful words to them, you can help them out of that bad mood. Our words are our spells. The way that we use our words, if it's in a positive way, our positive thoughts come out and we're putting that out into the universe. Again, whether it's spiritual and you're trying to manifest and you're asking the moon to deliver and you're sending out your wishes in the new moon, or you're just having a shitty day and you want it to improve. So you're talking to yourself, you're telling yourself it's going to be okay. They're all the same thing. Your spells, your words, your witchcraft, it's putting it out there and it's using these thoughts, these words, these spells to have a positive effect. So first of all, the words that you use, they're really going to have a positive outcome for all the things that I've just said there. So just thinking about next time you look at yourself in the mirror and the words that come into your head are fat, ugly, hate this, hate that, wish this was bigger, wish this was smaller, looking at your clothes, these don't fit, grabbing your skin. That's all going to have a negative effect on the way that your mind works for the rest of the day. You'll be looking at other people, comparing yourself, and just really bringing yourself down. You're not going to be happy. Flipping that. Seeing yourself in the mirror and like, oh my God, how amazing that I'm even here. I'm just cells put together. and looking at your body. And if you look at yourself when you've had children, instead of looking at, you know, the stretch marks, the lumps, the bumps and things that might be there after having children, how amazing you've brought another life into this world. How magical is that? And seeing it for what it is and not what's pushed on us through society and social media and magazines and these ideologies of how we're meant to look. So the power of your words, the magic of your words, using positivity to help you in that way works wonders. And it, like I said, I'm still working on this. I still have days where I'm like, oh my God, everything's going wrong. But I quickly now flip it to, okay, what have I got around me? Because I want to send out my spells of positivity and being grateful for what I have. Gratitude is the highest vibration. So again, whether or not you believe in frequency, vibration, or you have an understanding of that, or how manifestation, magnetization works, you will know that people say bad things happen, bad things come in threes. That's because if you're vibrating at a low level, of course bad things are going to happen. You're going to notice those bad things around you and call them towards you. If you're vibrating high, these things are still going to go on, but you're going to be looking at them from a different point of view. Maybe even looking at them and seeing what you can learn from that situation. So how else can we do this? Simple things, magic, dancing, singing, journaling. All of these things are going to help you to release. All of these things allow you to step into magic. When was the last time you felt terrible dancing? Or when you're home on your own and you're singing at the top of your voice and you sound like Alicia Keys, you feel crap. We don't. It's because it's bringing us up. It's bringing us into our high vibration. And it's also taking us back to times where we didn't have all these instant dopamine hits around us. The only ways that we could entertain and enjoy and have dopamine hits was from dancing and singing and being around people or being out in nature. And that leads me nicely on to the elements and connecting more with nature. Again, I ask you the question, when have you ever felt crap being in nature? Unless you're in England and it's peeing it down and you're soaking wet. But we'll forget that it's a nice sunny day and you're there. But connecting to plants and having that understanding that we too are plants. We have so many similarities. We need water, we need sun, we need soil, we need food. Okay, we're not going to eat the soil, but we need to be grounded. Have you ever felt off because you haven't been out in nature, or you just feel like you need a walk, you feel like you need fresh air? That is your body asking you to ground, so listen to it. And connecting with the elements as well also helps you to connect to your dreams, connect to your wishes. Asking for signs and symbols, and again, whether or not spiritual, woo-woo, whatever your thoughts are on that, just taking time when you go outside and having a look around you. Are you seeing the same bird over and over again? The other day I was sat in the garden, it was the new moon Saturday. I was preparing for the new moon, so I was making my manifestations, writing out my wishes, and a crow came to sit on the wall and was, do crows call, cawing, whatever their call is. So I just Googled it. I was like, right, what's this crow doing? And it sat there for ages. It wasn't bothered by the dogs. And of course, the spiritual meaning of crow, intuition, new beginnings, everything I've been journaling on during the day was sat on the wall in front of me. So again, just take time to see that magic around you, because there's maybe so many things that you're missing and that you're missing out on.
Just interrupting this episode to remind you to please like, subscribe, drop 5 stars if you enjoy listening to my podcast. It really does mean the world to me. And also to remind you, you can now watch every episode on my YouTube channel. Head to YouTube, type in Joanne Wealth, and I'll see you there.
Another way to help us to step into our magic, and I've spoken about this before on other podcasts, is to connect with your cycle. So again, science here. And I mentioned it just at the start of the podcast. As women, we have our 28-day cycle, same as the moon, similar to the moon. Have a look where the moon is at when you come onto your, when you come on your bleed. Mine's due today. It's a new moon. So currently in line with the moon. Having a look, noticing how you feel and tracking your cycle. So just very briefly, your cycle and the seasons, your winter, 7 days, your bleed. Think about how you feel in the winter, how you feel like you need to retreat, how you feel like you need to hibernate, stay inside, keep warm, keep cozy, rest. That's how we feel when we're bleeding. Listen to your body if that's what it's telling you to do. I had to lie down today on the sofa, had a bit of a headache, felt a bit tired, so I listened. I had stuff to do. I have my podcast to record, but I'm just going to lie down because I feel like this is what my body needs. So I did it. We then come into our spring. So after winter comes spring. Think about, again, the seasons. It's springtime now. We feel a little bit lighter. Plants and, you know, you see the daisies and the grass. We don't have the same seasons here in Dubai. I'm looking out the window. It always looks the same. But you see the daisies and the grass. We still have those wet days. It's not quite summer. Still can't trust the weather. And it's the same with our spring. So we're just coming out of our bleed, coming into our follicular phase. We're getting ready so that for the next cycle. Everything's growing and we're just feeling a little bit better, a little bit more alive. We then hit summer, our ovulation. Everything's ready to go again. So we are on it. It's sunny. We're having an amazing time. We've got loads of energy. If we're single, we feel like going out. You know, this is the time that if you're not single, you may feel like you're a bit more interested in your partner because your body is getting ready to be impregnated. That's what our cycle is for. Our body doesn't know if we don't want to be impregnated. So that's the, you know, it's there, it's ready. Everything's prepped and prime, ready for that fertilized egg. Then we come into autumn. Everything starts to shed again, the same as the leaves outside. So again, thinking about how you feel in autumn. Autumn's probably my roughest time internally. This is when I generally check my app and 7 days before I'm a bit grumpy, tired. Maybe I'll get a spot on my chin. And this is when I start to just up my self-care a little bit as well. Making sure I'm eating the right foods, lots of greens, protein. Again, the same as when we're coming up to winter in life, in the seasons. You know, we start to prepare for winter, don't we? We get our big jumpers ready. We maybe get the big bedding out. Whatever it is that you do for winter, do the same with your body. And then we go again, winter. So we have that cycle every single month, the same as the planet has this every single year. We go through the same. We have day, we have night, we have the moon, we have the seasons. We are a microcosm of the earth. And by connecting to that, and again, I know I've said it loads of times, but this is the podcast topic today. Stepping into that magic within you is really going to help, because once you have that connection with your cycle, you have a deeper understanding of your body. You can increase your self-care, your self-love. Changing your exercise to suit where you are in your cycle was a big changer for me. I look at where I'm at. I don't do any cardio when I'm on my period because I feel like it just wipes me out. Slow down my yoga, and then I start to increase it again for 3 weeks and then slow down again when my bleed comes. And you know what? That's fine. You're allowed to take rest days. Other women are different, and it's about learning about your body, your own internal magic. If you're not sure on some of the things that I've just said, go back through some of my podcasts. I think maybe towards the beginning, I haven't done a cycle related podcast for a while. Just go back and have a look, and you can dive a little bit deeper. So stepping into your magic again, how else can we do this? I wanted to share with you, I was doing a little bit of etymology. I love a little bit of history of words. And stepping into your magic also, I know I keep using the word witch, but stepping into being your own version of a sorceress. Source means to rise, and the suffix O-U-S, the us, means full of. So you're full of rising, you're ready to rise. So stepping into your sorceress era, rising, using your power. And again, spiritual or not, how amazing is that to just be like, yes, this is where I'm at. I'm stepping into my sorceress era. Say it right. So how else can we do this? Another way that I've been stepping into my sorceress era is to limit chemicals, limit the things that I'm putting onto my skin. Stepping back into my, I guess, my witch era of using plants to help me to heal, to help me to grow, to look after my hair, to look after my skin. And I was reading about where pharmaceuticals and the pharmaceutical big the companies came from. And I've lost the year now. I did have it written down. Let me just double check. I think it was 1902. No. Oh, I didn't write it down. I just read it. So it was Rockefeller. Was it J.D. Rockefeller? I'm guessing the Rockefellers of the Rockefeller Center in New York. It didn't specify, but I'm assuming. He actually worked out that you could turn petrochemicals into pharmaceuticals. And because he was so rich, he threw the finance at it. And gradually and gradually and gradually, chemicals rose and the use of plants and medicinals declined. So it's only been over the last 100 and let's just say 124 years, so we'll go back to the 1900s, that we've actually lost the connection to plants and healing. So just taking a moment to look at your medicine cabinet, look at your skincare, your hair care, and how can you take some of those things away and replace them with more natural products, with essential oils, natural oils. And again, I have previous podcasts on how I've done that and things that I've replaced. So please go back and have a look. I've got a full workshop on that. But this is going to then allow us to feel safer in our body. It's going to help us to keep our hormones balanced. And again, thinking of your body as the earth, would you go out and throw loads of chemicals in your garden? Or, you know, how do you feel when you see those oil tankers that have crashed in the ocean, but, you know, and there's all that black and we see the poor little birds covered in oil? That's how it can be, putting all of those chemicals onto our bodies. So again, seeing the magic of your body for the same way as we look at the magic of the planet. So stepping into your magic that way, allowing your body to have a rest from all the chemicals and see what happens. Because it's going to help you physically and possibly emotionally if they're messing with your hormones as well, which they do. Again, another big change for me, I've had this process over a few years now, only recently started to make huge changes. And it's still a work in process. I still have bleach in the cupboard downstairs, but my daily cleaning, I use my homemade mix. So that, you know, every little helps, not to quote Tesco. But if you're reducing the amount of chemicals you're using, obviously then when you do come to use chemicals, if you need to use that bleach or, you know, whatever it is that you're putting on to yourself, you can sit more safely thinking, right, okay, this is only a little bit rather than this whole lot that you may have been using before. Next. Allow yourself to grow. So allow yourself to step into your own magic. And one interesting thing that I read the other day was, again, as women, and I can only speak on behalf of women because I'm not a man, so this might be the case for men as well, but we've actually lost touch with our milestones. So as women, we go from maiden to mother to matriarch. Not always mother. Obviously, in my case, not a mother to a human, to dogs, maybe. So we have our maidenhood. We have our first bleed. In some cultures, the first bleed is still celebrated. And lots of others, and in most Western cultures, and in some religious cultures, it's seen as a really negative thing. We don't really celebrate it. We're not really, you know, we're not taken away and there's no party. It's just, this is going to happen to you for 40 years, like it or lump it. The next is from maiden to mother. And it was really interesting when I was reading about this, that that, yes, we might have baby showers, but we're not celebrating the mother there. We're taking the baby clothes. There isn't a celebration for you stepping away from your sovereign. So when you're a maiden, you're on your own. And then suddenly you are in charge of this whole new human. And yes, you might have a baby shower, you might have presents when you've had the baby, but we've lost this celebration. Years and hundreds of years ago, there would have been time for the mother. There would have been a huge celebration for the mother. Women would have gathered together to help her come through to this milestone. And that is lost. I have friends who've had babies and I'm guilty of it. It's just like, oh, they've had a baby. You go and see the baby. You ask how the mother is. But there isn't a sort of, okay, let's all get together to go through this together, this sisterhood of, going through to motherhood together. And the same for when we reach matriarch. So when we're older and we reach menopause, and menopause now has so much of a negative, it's getting better. There's a lot of change going on with menopause, but it's still dreaded. And I know a lot of friends who already are scared, worried, myself included. I don't really understand. No one's ever really spoke. I've done my own research. So I understand what's happening, and it's not a negative thing, but we don't have this, you've reached this point in your life, how amazing, and now everyone's going to come to you because you're the wise woman. It's kind of like you need to keep yourself looking young. You need to do this. You need to do that. And again, we've lost this milestone, this celebration. So the more you can do that for yourself, the better. Really celebrate yourself. If you haven't celebrated yourself becoming a mother, you might have teenagers now and think, no, I haven't. Go and do it. Celebrate yourself. Get together with other mums. No children allowed. No husbands allowed. And celebrate. And come together to talk about how it feels. Not talk about your kids. Not to talk about, the woes. How it feels, the growth, the power of being a creator, of being a mother. Do it. Celebrate it. Go and find it. Go and find each other. Sorry. I was just reading my notes then. What else have I missed? Because I feel like I, as you know, if you listen to this podcast, then you know that I do go off on a tangent. The witch wound. How can I talk about witches without... and spells and witchcraft and healing physically, mentally, emotionally without talking about the witch wound? And now I have whole podcasts on this. So today I'm just going to focus on how healing the witch wound can help us emotionally, physically, and to just get through every single day. Now, the witch wound you might have by looking at other women, feeling jealous, feeling competitive, comparing yourself to them. The first thing to do is identify, I have a witch wound. I identified this a long time ago. Sometimes I still feel it popping up. I feel like I could be triggered by some women. So now I delve deep and think, right, okay, where is this coming from and how can I work through this? Because if I don't, it turns into resentment. And then these feelings just live within our body rent free. So if you don't let these feelings go towards other women, it's resentment. Possibly hatred, dislike of you, dislike of them. And it's not a happy place to be emotionally, mentally. If we're comparing ourselves to other women all of the time, it can really affect our mental health, because then we start to look at ourselves. We hate what we see in the mirror. We, overthinking things. We're not inspired at all by other women. We're not inspired by ourselves. And we end up in this hole of dread and despair of ourselves. And this can all be linked to the witch wound. And again, I invite you here to just reflect, the same as I did, looking at people and thinking, right, why am I feeling like, why do I get triggered by this woman who does X or says this? Why is it bothering me so much? Because it shouldn't, and I should be supportive of her. And just noticing where that comes from. And it might also go back to something that happened in the school ground. And yes, we're adults now. women in 20s, 30s, even 40s, that we can still have sometimes these catty playground thoughts that hold us back, that don't make us feel too positive, good, amazing about ourselves. So reflecting on this and learning from it again, so you can step into your version of your magic. I've said a lot there without taking a breath. So one last thing that I want to talk about, that again I may have spoken about on another podcast when I was talking about witches, is that little voice inside us. Again, I know I keep saying this, woo-woo, spiritual, whatever you believe, we all have that inner critic, that inner witch hunter that holds us back. When we step into our true life and our true magic, when we step into our sorceress era, we have to learn how to quieten that inner critic, to quieten the ego. The ego, a lot of the time, stems from fear. Fear fuels the ego. So unless we're really facing life or death, a lot of fear is either learnt from parents or learnt from our environment. So fear, we're not born with fear. I think I've mentioned this before. I can't remember what it is now. I think there's only three things we're actually born fearing. You may have to go. I wasn't planning on talking about that. The rest is learned. And our ego feeds fear. And fear feeds our ego. And what that means is we might keep ourselves small, or we listen to the voice. You can't do that. You can't say that. She's better than you. You can't go there. She does this, so that means you can't. Look how good she is. This is all fear. By comparing and stopping ourselves from doing things, it's fear. There's so many things that I used to be afraid of, or I wouldn't do because of the fear of, I guess, looking silly. Or the fear of looking silly would come down to the fear of rejection, the fear of what people might say. And again, the fear of rejection is something I'm currently working on as well. And finding where this stems from. For me, when I've dived into where this fear comes from and where showing my true self comes from, it's definitely a witch wound with me. And not being confident or not wanting to speak up because of fear of persecution. And this has then manifested into my modern world of, you know, not overthinking things when I was posting on social media and taking so long to actually set up a podcast. It was all limiting beliefs. It was all fear. It was all fear of rejection. Now I'm at the stage of, yes, that still exists. However, now it's in different ways. If only one person listens to my podcast, I don't see that as a rejection. I see that as a positive. Wow, one person's downloading my podcast. One person's going to take 30 to 45 minutes to hear what I have to say. How amazing is that? So just working on that fear, allowing yourself to step into your more magical, your most magical version of you. All of these things that I've said today, I know I've gone through a lot. However, just working on one thing at a time. For you, it might be tuning in to your cycle. It could be going over and learning more about your witch wound and where that stems from. It could be learning more about your body. It could be just getting out in nature and seeing which part of nature makes you feel good. For me, it's the ocean. When I'm feeling crap, I get by water and I feel much better. And I tune into the water. And because of the practices that I've been doing over the past few months and really just allowing myself to step into my magical version, the most magical version of me, I'll talk to the ocean. What have you got to say to me? I'll ask the trees, I'll speak to the birds, lie on the grass, you know, all of these things. And I'll just close down my eyes and see what comes up. And those words that come up are those elements talking to you. And again, whether or not you believe in that, we all have this inner voice. Who is that? Is it the elements, your spirit guides, higher self, goddess, you know, your internal voice? It's you. Someone is talking to you in your head. And that's the voice that you need to listen to. The first thing that comes up, the things that might follow the things of, oh no, you're silly thinking that, then that's your ego. So the first things that come up, listen to that. If it feels good, if it feels powerful, go with it. If it feels icky, if it feels wrong, it's probably your ego, leave it. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for listening. I'm going to stop on that bombshell. Please, please, please reach out to me if you have any questions of how you can also step into a more magical version of you. If anything I said today really resonates, let me know. Or anything that you're not quite sure of, please reach out to me. And yeah, thank you so much for listening. Next week, have an amazing guest. She's here. She's going to talk to us all about how she healed twice from cancer using plant medicine. I will see you on the morrow. Thank you, thank you, thank you for listening. Thank you for watching.